Morning. I'll be talking on the about the control of the woolly apple aphid using entomopathogenic fungi. The woolly apple aphid is a serious pest of apple trees in apple-producing regions across the world, including production areas here in the Western Cape province. It has resulted in significant economic losses to the agricultural sector dealing with apple production. The presence of the aphid within apple orchards, the problem with it is that it results in fruit contamination through secretion of honeydew and infestation to the apple cultures. And the main issue, the other main issue with the woolly apple aphid is that it attacks the root system of the apple trees, and its presence on the root system results in formation of hypertrophic galls through its feeding, and the presence of hypertrophic galls on the plant root system is that it impedes the flow of nutrients and water from the root system of the apple trees to aerial parts of the plant. The main aim of my study was to conduct a survey of entomopathogenic fungi in local apple orchards and screen them for their ability to control the woolly apple aphid under laboratory conditions. From my survey of entomopathogenic fungi in apple orchards, I was able to collect 6 isolates of EPFs across 6 apple farms. And this slide just shows the difference between a treated woolly apple aphid and those, the difference between the healthy woolly apple aphid and the one that has been exposed to treatment of entomopathogenic fungi. Results from my study showed that 4 of the collected isolates showed a potential in controlling the woolly apple aphid, but however, further analysis showed that only 2 of the isolates, Metarhizium brunium and Metarhizium pinghensi, showed a greater potential in controlling the woolly apple aphid. This 2 graphs just shows how the woolly apple aphid response to treatment of Metarhizium brunium and Metarhizium pinghensi under different concentrations. And here you can see that Metarhizium pinghensi seems to show a greater potential relative to Metarhizium brunium in controlling the woolly apple aphid. And from my study, I can come to a conclusion that entomopathogenic fungi does show the potential to be used in biological control of the woolly apple aphid in apple orchards, and development of Metarhizium pinghensi as a biological control agent can be recommended from this study. I'd like to thank the following people for helping me with my research. Thank you.